स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी शैल कंप्लीट सेकंड पोइम एन एलिमेंट्री स्कूल क्लासरूम इन अ स्लम रिटन बाय स्टीफन स्पेंडर। स्लम एरिया विच इज़ नॉट फुली डेवलप्ड एरिया, लॉट ऑफ गार्बेजेस आर देयर, नो ड्रेनेज सिस्टम, नो सीवेज सिस्टम, वेरी पुअर कंडीशन पीपल आर लिविंग देयर। So here the poet is talking about the condition of those students, those who are studying in an elementary school which is established in a slum area. So let us see the poet, how he explains the conditions of the students. Far, far from gusty waves, these children's faces, like rootless weeds, the hair torn round their pallor. In the first stanza, the poet describes the physical condition of the students studying there. Far, far from gusty waves, the children's faces. इन बच्चों के जो चेहरे हैं, gusty waves, very strong waves, समुंदर की लहरों से powerful waves, उनसे काफ़ी दूर हैं. Like rootless weeds, the hair torn round their pallor. उनके जो बाल हैं, टोन राउंड देयर पैलर, पैलर का मतलब पेल फेस, उनके पीले चेहरे, पेल फेसेस, लाइक रूटलेस वीड्स, उनके जो बाल हैं उनके ऊपर ऐसे बिखरे हुए हैं जैसे कि रूटलेस वीड्स। वीड्स क्या होते हैं? अनवांटेड प्लांट्स होते हैं। व्हाट डू मीन बाय वीड्स? अनवांटेड प्लांट्स, जिसको खरपतवार के पौधे भी कहते हैं। तो जैसे वो जड़ से उखाड़ के फेंक दिए जाते हैं, मुरझा जाते हैं, मिट्टी से भर जाते हैं। सिमिलरली देयर हेयर टोन राउंड देयर पैलर। The tall girl with her weighed down head. Now the poet describes a tall girl with her weighed down head. Weighed down head, here it means that full of burden. She is the tall girl. The paper seeming boy with rat's eyes. One more student is there, paper seeming. Physical appearance is like a very slim and thin paper seeming. Paper ki tarah, kagaj ki tarah. With rat's eyes. Here rat's eyes means as a rat is always in the search of food, so here it means that hungry eyes, the hungry person. The stunt, one more student is there, the stunted, unlucky, hire of twisted bones, reciting a father's narrow disease, his lesson from his desk. Stunted means undeveloped. What do you mean by stunted? Undeveloped, इसकी अभी development नहीं हुई है। वन स्टूडेंट इज देयर हुज फिजिकल ग्रोथ इज नॉट देयर। द स्टंटेड अनलक्की हायर ऑफ ट्विस्टेड बोन्स, अनलक्की अभागा बच्चा, ट्विस्टेड बोन्स, उसकी जो बोन्स हैं वो ट्विस्टेड हैं, मुड़ी हुई हैं, प्रॉपर फिजिकल ग्रोथ ही कुड नॉट गेट। रिसाइटिंग ए फादर्स नैरल डिजीज, हिज लेसन फ्रॉम हिज डेस्क। Father's narrow disease. Narrow disease is a disease related to joints of bones. You see, we have read that twisted bones, where the bones are not fully developed. His father had been also suffering from this narrow disease. Same disease he got from his father. He inherited this disease from his father. Next is. At back of the dim class, one unnoted, sweet and young, his eyes live in a dream of squirrel's game in tree room other than this. At back of the dim class, here the poet also describes the condition of the classroom. In the classroom, light is not there, dim, darkness is there. One unnoted, sweet and young, very sweet and young boy has been sitting there unnoted because he had been sitting at the last desk. His eyes live in a dream of squirrel's game in tree room other than this. That boy is lost in a dream of squirrel's game in tree room. For example, his mind is busy in the squirrel's game. Squirrel game is there, coming in the tree room. This is a room, it has been called tree room. Hole in the trunk of the tree. Squirrel गिलहरी होती है, Squirrel is playing and squirrel is coming in this tree room and going back, coming and going back. That boy is busy, is having eyes live in a dream of squirrel's game in tree room. He is lost in that scene only. Other than this means this classroom. His attention is not in the classroom but towards tree room. So in this first stanza, the poet has described the condition of the students, physical conditions. Pale faces are there. Their hair had been compared with rootless weeds, like rootless weeds. Tall girl with her weight, tall girl is also in tension. Paper seeming boy, stunted, unlucky hire, suffering from neural disease. And the classroom condition is there, dim class. Let us proceed towards the second stanza of the poem. On sour cream walls, donations. Now the poet will describe in the classroom some pictures are given which some people had given in the donation. Some sceneries are there, photos are there. Shakespeare's head. In the first picture, Shakespeare photo is there. Shakespeare. Cloudless at dawn, civilized domes riding all cities. This is the photo of Shakespeare. Second is cloudless at dawn, civilized dome riding all cities. Cloudless, एक सीनरी ये ऐसी है, second one, जिसमें बादल नहीं है, sky जो है बिल्कुल blue है, आसमान खाली है. Civilized dome riding all cities. Civilized dome riding all cities means बहुत बड़ी बड़ी बिल्डिंगें जो हैं वो बनी हुई हैं, बहुत बड़े बड़े देशों की जो बिल्डिंगें वहाँ, खूबसूरत देशों की सिटीज़ की फ़ोटो उसमें बनी हुई है. नेक्स्ट है बेल्ड फ्लावरी टिरोलिस वैली. थर्ड एक और फोटो लगी हुई है. दिस इज सेकेंड फोटो. दिस इज द फर्स्ट शेक्सपियर. थर्ड फोटो कौन सी है? बेल्ड म्यूजिकल इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स फ्लावरी टिरोलिस वैली. एक फूलों की घाटी है जिसमें फूल ही फूल खिले हुए हैं. ओपन हैंडेड मैप अवॉर्डिंग द वर्ल्ड इट्स वर्ल्ड. फोर्थ नंबर पे पॉइंट से दैट देर इज वन मैप, वर्ल्ड मैप. अवॉर्डिंग द वर्ल्ड इट्स वर्ल्ड, ये फोर्थ नंबर पे मैप लगा हुआ है क्लासरूम के अंदर. एक मैप है विच इज शोइंग द वर्ल्ड. इसमें अमेरिका, ऑस्ट्रेलिया, बड़ी बड़ी कंट्रीज, जितनी भी कंट्रीज हैं ग्लोब पे, वो सारी उसके अंदर शो हो रही हैं. And yet for these children, these windows, not this map, their world, where all their future painted with a hope. Here the poet says that, poet is striking on this world map. Poet is striking on this world map. A classroom ke andar world map hai. And yet for these children, phir bhi in bachchon ke liye, these windows, ye jo classroom ki windows hain, Not this map, ये map नहीं, their world. Windows उनका world है, ये world map उनका world नहीं है. Where all their future is painted with a fog. जहाँ पर उनका future है वो अंधकार से भरा हुआ है. एक बार फिर से समझें, the poet is having a sarcastic comment on the world map. ये world map है. ओके, और वन साइड क्लासरूम विंडोज आर देयर. दिस इज क्लासरूम विंडोज. द पोएट इज सेइंग दैट एंड येट फॉर दीज चिल्ड्रन दीज विंडोज. विंडोज कौन सी? ये वाली. नॉट दिस मैप, ये मैप नहीं, देयर वर्ल्ड. ये विंडोज उनका वर्ल्ड है, ना कि वर्ल्ड मैप. इस विंडो में से क्या दिखता है उनको? जब वो विंडो में से बाहर देखते हैं तो उनको क्या दिखता है? गार्बेज, स्लम एरिया, क्योंकि स्लम एरिया में स्कूल है. जब स्लम एरिया दिखता है तो वही उनका वर्ल्ड है. वेयर ऑल देयर फ्यूचर इज पेंटेड विद ए फॉग. जो उनका जो फ्यूचर है वो फॉग से भरा हुआ है. इस वर्ल्ड मैप में कहीं उनको ऐसा सीन नहीं दिखता कि जहाँ उनको अपना स्लम एरिया नज़र आ जाए, बिकॉज यहाँ पर रिच कंट्रीज जो हैं वो शो हो रही हैं, अवॉर्डिंग द वर्ल्ड इट्स वर्ल्ड. अवॉर्डिंग द वर्ल्ड इट्स वर्ल्ड मीन्स वर्ल्ड ऑफ रिच पीपल, रिच कंट्रीज. लेट अस प्रोसीड नेक्स्ट. A narrow street sealed in with the lead sky, far, far from rivers, capes and stars of words. A narrow street sealed in with the lead sky. अभी आपने पिछली जो फोटो दिखाई थी उसमें मैंने स्काई दिखाया था, आसमान है, क्लाउडलेस, बादल नहीं थे उसमें. हेयर लीड स्काई, लीड स्काई का मतलब है यहाँ पर डार्क स्काई. इन द रियल सेंस देखा जाए तो उनकी लाइफ में क्या है, लीड स्काई है, डार्क ग्रे कलर स्काई है, मतलब अंधकार है. फार फार फ्रॉम रिवर्स, केव्स एंड स्टार्स ऑफ वर्ड्स, नदियों से काफ़ी दूर हैं, केव्स जो छोटे टापू हैं. स्टार्स ऑफ वर्ड्स, स्टार्स ऑफ वर्ड्स का मतलब है लिटरेरी पर्सन्स, जैसे कि शेक्सपियर की फ़ोटो लगी हुई थी, वो शेक्सपियर को क्या मोटिवेट करेगा वेन दे आर वेरी फिजिकली वीक एंड पुअर. Now the hair poets gives a comment on this sceneries in the third stanza. Surely Shakespeare is wicked. Wicked means bad. Surely Shakespeare is wicked. The map a bad example, with ships and sun and love tempting them to steal. The poet says that the map which is hanging in the classroom, it is a bad example because it does not show their own world. With the ships and sun and love tempting them to steal. With ships, such type of sceneries are there. Ships, sun, love, these all things tempting them. Tempting them means attracting them to steal. Attracting them to steal for lives that slyly turn in their cramped holes. Because their lives slowly turn in their cramped holes. Cramped holes means ब्रोकन हर्ट्स, जो उनकी जो टूटी फूटी झोपड़ियाँ हैं. लाइफ इज़ बाउंड अप टू दैट ओनली, फ्रॉम फोग टू एंडलेस नाइट, फ्रॉम फोग टू एंडलेस नाइट. लाइफ इज़ फुल ऑफ फोग एंड एंडलेस नाइट मीन्स ऐसी नाइट जो कभी ख़त्म ना हो, इट मीन्स डेथ. तो हेयर वी कैन से दैट फ्रॉम लाइफ टू डेथ their life is full of struggle, full of darkness. On their slag heap children wears, slag heap means garbage. On this slag heap these children wear skins peeped through by bones. Here again the poet describes the physical appearance of the condition of the students. They are having such type of thin skin that bones are appearing, skins peeped through by bones, हड्डियाँ तक दिखती हैं. And spectacles of steel, in the dim class they are studying, but their eyesights are weak. Spectacles of steel with mended glass, they are not wearing good glasses, spectacles, mended glass, broken glasses are there, like bottle bits on stones. Bottle bits on stone means breakage of the lenses. Here comparison is given here, like word has been used, simile. All of their time and space are foggy slum. The poet says that the whole time they spent in this foggy slum, so blot their maps with slums as big as a doom. Doom is the destructive day, end of the day, death day. But here the poet wants to say the last ultimate day, destruction. The poet becomes angry, that says that so blot their maps with slums as big as doom, bring such type of disaster that these maps should be blotted with the slums. The rich people map is there, that should be blotted with the slums so that they can also understand the conditions, miserable condition of the poor people. Here the poet also gives a suggestion how their condition can be improved. Unless governor, inspector and visitor, this map becomes their window. कि जब तक गवर्नर, इंस्पेक्टर, विजिटर, और जब तक ये मैप उनका विंडो नहीं बन जाता, कौन सा मैप जो क्लासरूम में टंगा हुआ है, विच इज़ हैंगिंग इन द क्लासरूम, दिस मैप बिकम्स ए विंडो एंड दीज विंडोज़, और ये जो क्लासरूम की विंडोज़ हैं, दैट शट अपॉन देयर लाइफ्स लाइक कैटाकॉम्ब्स, जिन्होंने इसकी लाइफ को कैसे बंद कर रखा है, कैटाकॉम्ब्स की तरह। कैटाकॉम्ब्स क्या होता है? अ वुडन बॉक्स टू कीप द डेड बॉडी, टू कीप द डेड बॉडी, ताबूत इसे बोलते हैं। इन दैट वुडन बॉक्स द डेड बॉडी इज प्लेस्ड एंड इन दैट बॉक्स डेड बॉडी गेट स्पॉइल्ड, गल जाती है, ख़त्म हो जाती है, डिस्ट्रॉय हो जाती है। सिमिलरली जो क्लासरूम विंडोज़ हैं, दोज आर लाइक कैटाकॉम्ब्स विच आर रॉटनिंग देयर लाइव्स वेयर दे कैन सी ओनली डार्कनेस ऑफ द फ्यूचर। द पोइट सेज दैट गवर्नर, इंस्पेक्टर, विजिटर, एवरीबडी विल हैव टू टेक सम स्टेप्स टू इम्प्रूव देयर कंडीशंस, अदरवाइज नथिंग कैन बी डन। Here again the poet gave some suggestions, break open till they break the town, word starting break, alliteration, break open till they break the town, break these windows, break all the barriers till they break the town, till they are converted into town, they are developed, and show the children to green fields in slum, leave these slum areas, take out those students from the slum areas and show them green fields and make their world run azure on gold sands. Make their world run means let them enjoy, run azure means blue sky. They should not live under lead sky, they should live blue sky upper side and on gold sands under their feet. A gold sand should be there in place of garbage. कूड़े की जगह क्या होना चाहिए? Gold sands. The poets give some more suggestions and let their tongues run naked into books, into white and green leaves open. The poet here is emphasizing on the education of these children. Let their tongues run naked. Here naked means freely. Full freedom should be given to them to read naked into the books, the white and green leaves open. Here green leaves open means let them enjoy good nature. Because the poet says that history theirs whose language is the sun. Itihas sirf unka hi hai, whose language is the sun. Here sun is the symbol of power, confidence. Sun is the symbol of power and confidence. The poet wants to say here that only those people can create, make or shape the history, those who are having confidence, power like sun. So history theirs whose language is the sun means these people should be made confident, these students should be made capable to face the challenges of the life, only then they will be successful in their life. So this is the poem, an elementary school classroom in a slum, where the poet was depressed about the miserable condition of the students studying there, and in the end he gives a hope that all the political leaders, governor, inspector, visitor, everybody should think something about these students also for their development, because they are the part of our country. So I hope you well understood this poem, read this poem and complete its question answers. Thank you. Bye bye.